Hi everyone, right, so today I'm going to go through an updated combo tutorial of the Naturia Runick deck. I did very basic combos before in a quick video, but to be honest that was more explaining like the cards and what they did and then just showing you sort of basic lines. This is going to be a bit more in depth, so we're just going to start with a couple of test hands, but I'm going to try and make sure that the hands are exactly like this. That's exactly what I wanted to see. So we've got basically two Naturia cards and then two Runic cards and then just a random card. This one doesn't really matter. So what we're going to do is in the draw phase, start off with Flash and Fire Summon. Huge in effect. Pitch this. Oh, this is a Sunflower, by the way. I don't. It's. It's not here yet. Royal Mail. Then we're gonna go goods first, just to like try and play through the Ash, if there is one. And goods is gonna pitch the tree, which is gonna search the blessing. So all we've done so far is runic into the fountain, so we're just sort of molding our hand. Got the fountain going, got the wings going, and got into the blessing. Now what we're going to do is go normal Camellia. Camellia is then going to pitch the Mall Cricket. We're then going to use the Blessing to bring back the Mall Cricket. We're then going to use the Camellia, sorry, the Mall Cricket to summon from deck, and then the Camellia to pay its cost to mill two. So replace its cost by milling two. Decent mills, I suppose. And then summon out a Camellia from the deck. Then now, what we can do is we can. This doesn't play around like Nib or anything. You can synchro these two into Coral Dragon. Can activate the fountain. Then at this point, I would use Tip to search. Just any of them, really. Probably search of destruction actually, keep that at the bottom because it's probably not probably going to be no, I'd search of slumber because it's probably going to be the least important one. Then that's in the grave. Obviously, tip was good to draw, but you know, this I'm only using this anyway, so this could have been this as well. Into this, then fountain effect three back to the bottom, draw three new cards. Then synchro these two into Baron. Coral Dragon effect, draw another card. Synchro these two into Beast. So now your hand is four cards in hand. You've got the Cricket to summon back in your grave. You've got you can't summon the Camellia though because you milled the Camellia. So you would have to Bless and Reborn the Camellia. But then the Camellia could also bring back something else. Then the cricket could tribute, Camellia could mill two to bring out the sunflower if you wanted to, or you could just tribute the cricket to bring out the sunflower. Then you would have two monsters in the gate. So your board could very much look like so let's say we just bless in for the Camellia, then it goes to their turn. They summon a monster from the extra deck, you bring out the cricket. Cricket effect, tribute itself, bring out the sunflower. You then have sunflower effect negate, but the Camellia can do the cost. Then you have the sunflower negate, so it's two monster negates, unlimited spell negate, and then this is either you're like you evenly negate or your like any other trap negate basically, or maybe something that was gonna chain to stop something somehow, but obviously beast can be activated multiple times a chain, so there's no need to worry about that. So all spells are off. Like I say, I believe sunflower can be used multiple times a chain as well. I don't think they would have written once per chain that many years ago when sunflower was originally released. So you know, two monster negate and destroys, unlimited spell negate, and then either a third monster negate or a trap negate because you're never going to use that for spells. And then obviously you pop in. Your beast is popping possible milling, even though if they start to play into beast, they've lost. There's no point. They should never ever try and play into beast. But then you get the two mills from Cremelia as well. So basically, you should be stacked up to keep drawing off the runic cards, and you probably could even deck them out. So I'm just going to give this a quick shuffle, because when the thing you've got to realise with this deck is when you're more cricketing, your more cricket and your Camellias always stick together. And then if you do in the play where you're more cricketing and the Camellias cost, and then you get another Camellia out of the deck, well, then you're going to have two Camellias and a more cricket really close together. So it's really important to shuffle this deck as well. Obviously, all the runic cards stick. So I'm just going to do this combo like one more time. Let's have a look. This is an interesting one. So I've shown the standard combo line. Now I'm going to have a little think about this. But basically, we're always sort of, this in the draw phase. Hujin's effect. Get the fountain. Anything you should, I don't know, I'm trying to think, I'm not sure this combo, it's tough. So you go normal this, obviously, tribute this off into Camellia effect, it's going to send a tree at this point, tree effect, bring back the blessing. Then I think, because you can't get the monsters on the field, I suppose Blessing Cricket probably isn't full combo, but I suppose you could draw into it. So this is definitely the play where I would go to make, Baron first. So I'd go Coral, Fountain, this to summon, Fountain effect to put these three at the bottom, and draw three. Then synchro these two into Baron. Coral to draw another one. Then obviously here you could just did I cheat? I feel like I cheated there. Yeah, those two are supposed to go in a. No, I didn't cheat. Yeah, because those two go in a Coral, and it is. Because then you've got your double blessing now to bring back these two, and then these two synchro and a beast. Yeah, so it is, yeah. So yeah, that's just, it's just working out on the fly. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna quickly summarize that hand again, because I know I probably wasn't very clear. So it was those two. Oh, I think it, yeah. So it probably has to be like three. Oh, it doesn't have to be three runic cards. Yeah, so these two still work, so I'll just put them evenly in here just again. So just to run through this combo one more time. So yeah, you would slumber into this, effect of this, search this, normal this, effect of this, Camellia effect, pitch the tree, search a second blessing, fountain, well you don't need to do fountain just yet, but synchro those into Coral, fountain, special, brought it up here, I don't know, I've done that. Synchro these two to Baron. Draw another card. You're supposed to put these two back to draw two more as well. I'm just going to put this to the bottom so it's not part of it. So there were the two I drew off the Fountain and the one I drew off the Coral. Double Blessing. Camellia and more Cricket. Then you got Beast. So it is literally any two Runic cards, any two Naturia cards. To be honest, arguably that this is even better because this plays around it because you make the Baron first. So things to say about this board. It's obviously incredibly resilient into almost anything. Obviously, what we've got to look into in the meta at the moment is standard engine. Like this negating everything from the Kashtira board is really good, like all the spells. Then the Baron being able to just negate and destroy anything. Obviously, they could Spectre Fenrir and Fenrir Tackle of Beast. But then what you've got to understand is that if you get either Tip or Flash and Fire, a Tip or a Flash and Fire in the battle phase would be ridiculous. That's six cards you can use there. You could have hard opened the other Blessing, or a tree, because you could have pitched that off Hugin's, or a Foolish Goods. And then that could literally just rub on the beast in the battle phase. And as well, I think that's about it. But the, you know, there's a lot of potential to keep this beast on the waste of the battle phase, and then it goes back to your turn and you're playing Runic, and if there's someone for next year, you get them all quicker back. There's a lot more pushes. So so there's just a lot of this board is quite resilient. Kaiju over the beast does hurt, so that is a bit of a problem. But yeah, so we've done three test hands now. One was the same hand basically. But you know, a lot of the cards go in the same way. A lot like the turns go in the same way. But this is just a bit more advanced combo where basically all you're doing instead is just getting the Nat Beast on the board as well. So I think we'll just do one more. That is brutal. We can do this in the standby. Let's say in the draw. And make this, pitch the evenly, search fountain. So all we can do at this point is just draw and hope to get there, so then we can play. I don't even think we can get a draw three here. No, I don't think we can get a draw three because you just don't have the cards. See, I think you have to go fountain to search. You'd actually have to grab something useful here in case you don't draw anything. So then we get a draw two, which isn't bad. There's a lot of cards out of the deck now. These two are at the bottom. Hoping for a Naturia card. Not Naturia cards, right? This makes it a bit difficult now because there is literally nothing you can do with Sunflower Runic Wings. So I think you just have to set these. Hope you survive with these. And then go from there. But I suppose that's important why I said I didn't five shuffle there. It's definitely important to shuffle with this deck because like I said, all the Runic cards come together and all the Naturia cards come together. So let's have a quick look. Are we gonna draw a playable? Right, this actually is playable. So we can dispel in, search fountain, activate fountain, activate tip to search, flash and fire, draw three. Now we see a Naturia card. Yeah, perfect. So this is exactly what I meant about this deck, where you can draw into the Naturia stuff as well. So if you Foolish Goods here, send the tree, get Camellia, normal Camellia, pitch the cricket, use the blessing. More cricket to tribute, Camellia to pay the cost. Met Coral. Bring out the Jerry. Synchro. Draw one off the Coral. So now, first action in their turn, they drop a Fenrir, Flash and Fire 8, draw 3. So the deck is extremely solid. And it's got Runic cards in, so I like it. And that is a great example of you can do the Runic stuff, and you're going to get a draw 2, and you can... You know, you can possibly get somewhere, even when you don't open the Naturia cards, you can actually get into, you can use the Runic cards to search stuff. So, like, that is a possibility. But yeah, I hope this combo throw is useful. I did Baron that beast very often. Showed how to get there without the opening Naturia cards. And showcase the deck that it can brick. So that's not great. It, like I say, it's not as consistent as the Sprite deck, the Sprite Light Twin deck, the Sprite Runic deck, but it is more powerful because you get a Nat Beast and a Baron. So yeah, cheers for watching. Hope you enjoyed.